I didn't know what to do, too. I did not have home, I did not have family, but wanted help. I wanted to help. And finally, I find out when the liquidation will be. Okay? So I told them, I didn't want them that day go to the barracks, you know. I say that's the day that, in meantime, the major find the villa. And he called me and he said, I have a villa, I want you to be my housekeeper. I did see the villa, I knew that there is a place. It's just, and I trusted that it's in the last minute. It is special for me. God gave me, put me in the right place at the right time, and that's it. But the people were living there. One family Jewish, not Polish, one family Ukrainian. And the time was so short. I was racing against time. Polish family left. The Ukrainian family, they talked to media alone, and they got exception that they will leave, you know, 2 days later. And the time was there that was coming, that that will be the last thing. So they will, I liked them. Six of the people left for the forest. I helped them, smuggling them out to the forest.
From the laundry room?
From the laundry.
How did you do that?
Well, I work with the Christian girl, Helen, you know, that was married to the Jewish man, you know. Helen took work on a farm. She special took a farm, you know, and she sent it a slate. I mean, she sent it a car, a horse in a buggy, and the people were hiding and did not go to the ghetto or the, to the work barracks, hiding in a park. You know, the, on the way to the forest. And so I was...
Which people were hiding in the park?
Six Jewish people.
The six Jewish people who had been in the laundry.
Yeah.
She took them to the park in this horse and buggy.
Yeah, and I took them to the forest.
From the park?
Yeah.
In the same horse and buggy? And where were they? Were they underneath some...
Trees and this, you know.
And did you hide them in the buggy too?
Yes. Covered them.
With what?
Blankets and put hay and not, it was not baggy, it was like a wagon, you know.
Yeah.
And I look like a farmer bringing some things, and I dropped them off in the forest, so there were only six left in a, in there.
Were this, they all women left?
No, men and women. It was Fanka Zilberman, there was Ida Haller with the husband, and Clara Bauer. And I have to look at it, so many. Mm. But anyway, I locked them in the laundry room. And I said, well, tomorrow, you know, the people moved out the Ukraine, and I will open the door and we'll let you go, you know. So, but did not happen that way, because next day in the morning, I heard that there will be a Gestapo searching all over the places where Jewish people were working. Two German secretaries were saying, oh, dress nicely because tomorrow the handsome assessment will come, you know, and they will find, you know, she said, you know, they hiding? They hiding? And when they, she's, my feet were trembling. I was so scared. I didn't know what I would look. There is a six people in there, and I knew if Gestapo would walk there, they will find them, okay? So during the night, that night, there was a performance from Berlin, a German artist coming, and the whole plant, you know, the German officers were going. I didn't know. I could not take them to my room because it's small, but I took two and hide them in my room in the closet. And four, I smuggled on the third floor to the German major apartment suite.
You took them upstairs to the major suite?
At night. And there was a, above the bathtub was like a little window, not past the air vent, okay? I did see that air vent 1,000 times, but didn't pay any attention. But when I needed the place, it comes to focus there. So I took the chair, I climbed, I took the net, you know, and did see that was a, not big there, but was a big air vent. And in Poland, the walls are very heavy. And I did see like a little light on the other side. There were, I put four of them.